So Umang sir, Mary Kom and now there's Sarabjit, both of them biopics. Were they specifically designed like that or?
No, I mean, I've said this before also. It's not specifically designed that if one biopic runs, I'm supposed to make another one. It just so happened that Sandeep came with the idea to me that this is a fantastic subject, please have a look. Once I saw it online, I was so mesmerized by Dalbir Kaur and the story that I said, okay, I have to do this film. And it hit me somewhere, I said, my God, this is a hard-hitting story and a life that people know of, but they don't know the depth of it. And that's why I thought we should make this film.
Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, the hardest part of playing Sarabjit, because entirely in the movie, it's emotional, it's draining. It must have been really difficult for you to essay the character, but I would like to ask you, how difficult, how challenging was the role of Sarabjit Kaur? Dalbir Kaur.
To begin with, when Umang came to me with the subject, it was an immediate yes. He's already shared that with you. Because when you hear the story, I mean, I'm sure you all already got the feeling, the vibe of it when you saw the trailer right now. How can we walk away from being a part of telling the story and sharing it with everybody, especially the human story? We are all familiar with the reportage, and thank you all for doing what you do day in and day out. But nevertheless, there are a lot of, as I started out saying today, that we all still individually as Indians continue with our lives. We do get affected, we do get disturbed, but we don't necessarily can possibly experience or take the minute out to experience how an incident can completely change the dynamic of a family, can change the lives of a family. And it was important to be part of that narrative and to share it with us Indians. Sarabjit's life cannot go, his story cannot go unknown. And Dalbir fought for over 23 years, relentlessly. I mean, this kind of sibling love and commitment, the lady's capacity to be Sarabjit for his family, to be Sarabjit's Dalbir Penji for him, to be Darji's spirit and strength to be able to keep the fight on going is just a commendable, unbelievable spirit. And there, I think, adjectives fall short to describe that spirit which exists in so many households of our country and worldwide. So this story needed to be told. And thank you, Umang, for bringing it to me. Thank you, Utkarshini, for writing the way that you have. And thanks to the whole team for us bringing it to life.
Thank you so much. Randeep Hooda, you're a fantastic actor. I mean, what more can I say? It's very difficult to actually, and as actors, you know, you guys do different sort of characters, weight loss kar liya, weight gain kar liya. I mean, personally, I want to know, how do you lose so much weight and then you do the other things that you do and with such finesse and honesty? How did you do it?
I was...
Yeah.
The hard part of a character, of course, weight loss and all that is something we had decided, and it took a lot of willpower to achieve that. But the hardest part of the character was the fact that a lot is known and documented about Dalbir Kaur. Not much is known about him and his prison life. So that, to keep it true and to keep it within the script and keep it as honest as possible, and to go through the suffering he did for 23 years, where out of 18, out of that 18 years, he was locked up in chains and was in a Kal Kotri. So imagining all that was the harder part. With Umang and as a co-conspirator, it was very easy. And I feel that everybody in the cast has done a fantastic job. And I'm very proud to be a part of this movie. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Randeep. Honey, you've always been known to make entertainers. Sarabjit is a very serious biopic film. Is Pooja Entertainment trying to move in a new direction?
Well, we're always making wholesome family entertainers, and we were waiting to carve a niche for our company. And this is such meaningful cinema, and we wanted that space. So when Umang bought the script to us, and when we went through it, we literally had tears in our eyes. And that's the reason the trailer has left me shocked on the big screen. You know, I am out of words, but that's the reason we all decided to go with this film.
Right. Bhushan ji, kya baat? Like the music that you make, the films now with Airlift 2016 and now Sarabjit, kya baat hai? What have you been eating and doing?
See, the thing is, people used to know us with musicals, but after Baby, we changed our perception by making Baby and then going on to Airlift, which audience and everybody liked a lot. So, and this Sarabjit is again a very real and true story, and I'm sure everybody will love it and give that kind of respect and love to this film. And we are very proud to work with the entire team of Sarabjit, especially the National Award winning director, Mr. Umang Kumar, who has given a Maricom. And this I've seen some visuals of the film, and I can't explain. You have to see to believe it. Thank you.
It's pretty hard hitting. We've seen the trailer and we absolutely believe it. We can't wait for the film to release. But Richa Chadha, sorry, took you by surprise. You are taking us by surprise with every role that you portray. With this film, what were your challenges and what was so interesting about the character?
For me, I read the script. It took me about 2 days. And I understood the weight of my character. Of course, it's supporting these two primary characters. But my deep down belief is that, you know, I feel like politicians have kind of failed to create peace. So it's only up to artists and musicians and writers. And honestly, it sounds very like, whatever, preachy, but that's really my core belief, that it's only via films like these that we can possibly reach out and create some kind of... This film is about the human side of... the human casualty of conflict, whether it's India-Pakistan or terrorism or whatever. But it's the lives behind the statistics. And that's what really interested me. And of course, the director, the writer who I know, and the incredible cast. I've worked with Randeep before and I'm sweating because I'm intimidated by him always. But I'm really proud to be a part of this film.
Very well said. Thank you so much, Richa. Coming on to Darshan Kumar, you're looking really hot. Sorry, I had to crack this line. But can I please ask you about your role, about the challenging parts of it? It's an emotional film. It's a serious film. Yes, over to you, sir.
I would like to say thanks to Umang sir, Sandeep sir, Vanita ji for giving me this chance to work in this film. Such a beautiful story. I just love the story. And I got a chance to work with versatile actors like Ash, Randeep, Richa. It was such an amazing journey, I would like to say. And I'm playing Awais Sheikh, a Pakistani lawyer. I think he's a fighter. A common man did an extraordinary thing for humanity. So, jo maine role ye padha, padhte, I felt like, wow, this I have to do it. And it was such a nice journey. And I just love the film.
Thank you so much, Darshan Kumar. Thank you. Coming on to Jackie, you guys are the next generation of Pooja Entertainment, and why debut with Sarabjit and no other film?
Good evening, everyone. You know, the story struck a chord with me as soon as I heard it, and I know Umang sir for a long, long time, and even before he made Maricom, and I always believed that this man will be one of the biggest directors we'll ever see. Also, this story is about a relationship between brother and sister, and I know for a fact that main apni behan ke liye kuch bhi kar sakta hu aur main ye confidently keh sakta hu ki wo bhi mere liye kuch bhi karegi. I know Ash
jail mein band hona padega uske liye
aur main Ash ko janta hu bahut saalon se to wo bhi ek tha, and Randeep I'm a big fan of. Maine 60 kilo kam kiye hain lekin maine to hero banne ke liye kiya tha, but jo aapne kiya hai, hats off. Richa, outstanding. Darshan, Bhushan sir, we all know you're a tycoon. So I'm just happy that I'm a small part of this. But I just want to say that there's a man called Sandeep, who's also a big part of this film, Vanita Kumar. This film looks the way it looks because of her, not because of Umang sir. So,
and
these
and
two...
And please call Utkarshni up also. Utkarshni Kamara.
Kiran,
you deserve to be here.
And Kiran sir, sorry sir.
Kiran sir, yeah, he's...
He's made, Kiran sir has made the frames and, come alive.
And,
absolutely.
When you want weight tips lost, please, you can come to me. Thanks.
And I just wanted to ask you the reasons why you thought you should be producing Sarabjit.
I think everybody has spoken about it.
Absolutely.
So I just say it has taken 17 years of my life to be in the industry to produce one film. And when I believed in this subject and I went to Umang, Umang immediately said no, because not of the story, because he did not wanted to direct another biopic. And then when he saw the footages, he said, let's do it. So I'm thankful to Bhushan ji, Vashu ji, Jackie, Deepshika, who came along and believed in us. And this is our first production and we have produced this. And I was waiting for this day to come. And I could see that after the trailer, with the tears of Aishwarya Rai Bachchan in her eyes. And thank you, Randeep. You have really, really worked very hard in this film. Thank you so much, mere bhai. You have given a lot to this film. Richa, thank you for accepting this role, Darshan. Thank you. Kiran, sir, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Manu. And all my team. And special thanks to my best friend who supported me in this film is Neeraj. He always tells me not to take his name, but I want to really thank you. You have been a great support on this film. And I can't take everybody's name, but I'm thankful to each and every person of my team, whether it's Zafar, Akshay, or art department, or Shail, Pitesh, Rajesh, Jayesh, everybody has worked. Kush, thank you so much for all your support. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you so much. So now, the media, if you've got any questions, please. They're all yours.
Hi, Aishwarya ma'am. This is Urvi here from Pinkula.
Hello.
Hi. Ma'am, this role is emotionally demanding and draining. What was the kind of preparation that you went through when you had to do this role?
Actually, this is possibly one of the fastest films we've ever made in our careers. I think that holds true for most of us here. So credit goes to the potential of the subject itself, the director helming it. That's why I keep saying, actually, I'm going to name each member of the team. The producers who have come on board and helped us infuse it with the life that we wanted to. Vanita for creating the ambience where we just naturally felt we are part of this narrative. We are the characters that we are. Shahid Amir for keeping with Umang and all our vision for the way we want to essay the characters and not making it about chalo hum aisi film bana rahe hain. It's not about that. It's about being sensitive to the palette. And I think having Umang and Vanita and someone as experienced as Kiran G, I'll say, just for the experience, but he's called KD by the team. Okay, so he has literally brought our world to life. And whatever we all might strive to do an essay, if he is not out there capturing it, we are all done in for. So genuinely, a huge round of applause. I always have the highest respect for the DOP there on set, because we all can do what we want. You can say action, cut a million times. We can all do 100 takes and retakes. But every little nuance, if not captured, the way we want essayed by him and his team, gaye kaam se. So it's really a huge thank you to him and his team, all the assistants who strive day in and day out, relentlessly. When we do such a fast project, believe you me, it's 48 hours and 24 each day, and that's the way we've worked. So I think that'll give you an insight into the preparation. Dive into the deep end and swim. That's what we all have done, but the power remains in what we had to begin with. And that's why we always say script, Hence, Utkarshni definitely deserved to be up here on stage. You know, when the writing has it all, and as a team, we work together on set genuinely as artists. We all can come together and bring to life every day. This is one of those movies where the oddest answer I think anybody can give here saying is, it was a pleasure doing this role. Because that's something you cannot say. It's too intense, too disturbing on a daily basis. But as artists, I'm sure we all feel grateful to have got an opportunity to essay these characters and tell their story to you all, the audience.
Hi, Aishwarya, here on your right. Right. Yes. Looking gorgeous. Okay, my name is Nilesh from Think Market Magazine. When the makers approached you for this role, what was the thought process? What was your thought process? What were the challenges? And how did you overcome it? The same question would be for Randeep as well. Let's start with Aishwarya.
Well, just to, I think, keep the proceedings faster, I think I more or less answered a large part of that question when I was answering the lady on my left. But I would like to add one thing, though. The subject concerned here, when we're telling the story, albeit for my character's perspective, I was obviously listening. We always listen to the story as a whole. I think definitely committed actors and artists, we are always happy to tell a story as a whole. We don't necessarily focus on our individual parts. And when we feel there is the potential and the power and the impact in the narrative, all of us are like-minded here. We're happy to come on board. And that you can gauge from our career graph and choices. So Dalbir's character and Dalbir's story, this was strong because I felt maybe I'm having trouble with recollection, but my immediate response was, it's rare that there's such insight given and such attention a narrative can bring to this kind of sibling commitment, this kind of the sibling relationship. If you take away from the potential of the actual, the real story, if you look at it, if you do balka khalo for narrative and say, acha, as a character, aisa dekha jaye to. So that's one way of looking at it. But more than anything else, I don't know, it's some kind of divine calling because 10 years ago, or approximately in that phase, being a member of the film industry or the kind of wonderful privileges that being celebrity gives us, the opportunity, we don't even possibly realize the potential so often. We stand on so many platforms, we are a part and a voice for so many different causes, and we all largely make the time. We do all that we can in our capacity, and I say limited capacity because sometimes everybody forgets that we are largely artists. So our day in and day out, we are going on morn to evening. That's our office. That's our job. We're going, making movies, coming away. But then in the extra time, we're trying to definitely do all this as well. It was a letter, that a petition that was going around to some of us who belonged to the public platform, one of them being me. And I too was amongst the members of the film industry, I guess, who were called. I know my father-in-law too was had also signed on for the petition. At that time, not my father-in-law. And me, because that's what I was told. And the letter had come to me as well to sign on a petition while possibly Dalbirji was trying everything possible to bring attention to work at his release. And the moment Umang told me, this is the story of Sarabjit, I had this expression in my eyes and he said, "Kyun? Kya hua?" I said, "Oh, Umang," which is very him. So I said, "Umang, this is some kind of divine calling. And of course, I will hear the whole story." But it was already a yes. I was definitely going to come on board because somehow he and his life and mine had kind of, albeit, like I said, just a petition being signed, but it had crossed. Our paths had crossed. And still, unfortunately, he did come back to India in a coffin. I had. my Odin respects, and I was happy to come on board. Just a minute, Randeep had to answer.
Sorry, bro.
This.
Can you repeat the question?
What preparations?
No, let him repeat the question. My thought process. Well, first time I had seen all those footage, and when he died, I was aware of what that happened. First time I read about Sarabjit movie being made was when somebody forwarded me an article where Dalbir, the real Dalbir Kaur, was saying that she would like me to play the role. And I was like, really? So then I looked up, did more research about him, and by the time I met Umang, I knew him very well. And then Umang gave me some letters, some photographs. There was only one video footage. So I went about learning the Punjabi, and then we discussed how do we make a difference in his 23 years of his life. So we went about, we decided that, okay, let's let him lose weight so that, you know, his plight comes across even more to the audience. So that took me a lot of time and a lot of unhealthy things. So that was one part of it. And then I realized that, you know, what can happen worst in the jail was the tooth decay. So I went to Canada, and I went for the Toronto Film Festival. So there I met this guy who makes molds, who makes monsters in Hollywood movies. So I got him to make me a mold and send me 3 stages of his teeth. Apart from that, you know, I went through the letters. I made his thoughts mine. I made his words mine. I think I have written many letters which I have not sent to Umang, and which I will never send, because now I read them and I think they're too personal. I used to sit at home and in the chains and, you know, lie in my bathroom for a long time and write letters to Umang as if he was my sister, but I would address it as Umang. Sorry, Umang. If you love me enough, I'll give you those letters. So I went through the whole journey of 23 years. I tried to go through the whole journey of 23 years of solitude, of the things. You know, the first thing what would a person dream about? What would a person think about lying alone in darkness for so many years? That, as I said earlier, was left to our imagination, because that was not documented. So as a person, I thought how to make it real for myself is to try and go through it, through the starvation, through the solitude, through darkness. Your mind plays tricks on you when you're in the dark, man. You talk to yourself and all kinds of things happen. So that was, I think it's one of the most prepared roles of mine, and it took me a few months to get the mindset, and Umang was actually going to shoot the Dabang village portions till he dropped the bomb on me before Diwali and said, "Ki, I'm going to shoot this." So I had a very short time to catch up with the weight loss, but I did it. And somewhere that has instilled in me a sense of belief and a sense of my own willpower, which I think will help me in other parts as well.
Umang?
Sorry. Before you, there was a lady who's lined up. So maybe later. Yes.
Umang? Hi.
Yes.
What kind of creative liberties or freedom have you taken to make this biography? Because after all, commerce is also important. So can you tell us?
No. Commerce, physics, science, nothing is used over here. We made this true to the heart. What Dalbir told us, what her story was, we followed exactly that way. Okay, emotions run high, because if you've seen her videos, she also does, you know. So I wanted to capture that completely, and that's what I had told Ash also. Okay, this is what I look for the role. Sarabjit as a character, Randeep said, we knew very less about, only the things that Dalbir personally had told us. So the preparations for the film was exactly like what if Dalbir was part of it. So we've stayed true to the story completely. We've not changed anything, okay? Because it's a written fact, you can see it, you can Google it. The dates, weights, everyone knows about it. So it's true to the facts.
Aishwarya, hi. My question is to you. You are so stunning that you sometimes feel you're so stunning that you sometimes feel you have to be de-glammed in order for that acting prowess to show through. And also, this look of yours is so drastically different. So when you looked into the mirror, were you shocked, saddened? What was the first feeling?
Saddened.
I'm like,
even we were saddened.
Transformation.
As actors, we wait for the opportunity where we get the chance to essay a character and a role in its entirety. And, you know, the visual is the most important aspect, because every waking day when you get off your vehicle and get into your trailer and your tracksuit or however you come to work, it's important to become the character. So when you look into the mirror and if you see the character, believe you me, it's elation. I probably even use that word because you've used saddened. I don't even think we go through elation, you just become the character. And that's something that has always been important to me as an actor. And that doesn't remain subjective only to the genre of film that we're today talking about. That remains true to every genre. It's important when you look in the mirror, like we have the highest respect for our makeup tools, for costume. We always call that Saraswati. Every morning when we come to our trailer, we'll see to that our feet are not on the table. You know, it's respect of the highest order. And every aspect of getting ready to go face the camera is crucial to bringing to life what's written. And that's why we always mention and reiterate team effort. Every professional who's there on a set contributes to bringing what you see here on celluloid. So it was important for us to play Dalbir, especially as Umang has already shared with you, and you all can see and you all know, that we don't necessarily, we don't physically actually look like each other, even in terms of height and everything else. And yet, Umang was very clear that he said, look, I want you to essay this part. So you're playing Dalbir. So let's create a character together where you, at the end of it, come away experiencing, feeling, believing Dalbir's story. And that is what is important. And it is very gratifying to have evoked the response today in your applause. Of course, for the entire film, but none of you went, eh? When you have looked at even the poster or what I've essayed. So if you feel it is the story of all characters belonging and it feels real and feels true, then we have succeeded. And then, of course, we bring together all the tools that we need to bring that truth, that honesty to the character essayed. So if we felt that, you know, it's reality. We have Dalbir ji on board. So it's reality. We've got referencing in terms of the material that you, the media, have documented to gauge mannerisms. Beyond that, I have not spent time with her before the film. In fact, I even met her for the first time on the first schedule of our set. I did not meet her in advance. Because when I'm playing real life characters like this, where actually you don't obviously see a similarity, it's important for me then as an actor to remain true to the director's vision and the director's narrative while nuancing the character in a way that when you see, as he said, when she speaks, when she's spoken at public forums, then there is a certain natural use of hands. There is a certain physicality in the way she expresses herself. That's referenced by what you have documented. So that is something that we have brought to for those occasions. But then I have not necessarily sat and watched every little twitch, blink, sniffle or smile of hers to only reference that. It's important to remain true to what we are emoting on a day-to-day basis. Also in terms of physicality, while on one level we could have gone down the path that a lady who is going through this kind of hardship and strife over 23 years. Now you can hit either of the spectrum of change in physicality. Either you can show loss of weight because of the kind of stressful lifestyle, or the other way around. And we chose together to go the other way around. I remember we both smiled about it, and Umang is a dear friend. I've known him for long. So he just says, you've just lost weight. You sure? you want to go the other way? And I was like, yeah, let's do it. And of course, we did it with costuming and, you know, padding and all of that, and really building on the physicality of the character in the timeline of the film. And then little things like, obviously with stress, you could be you could be prematurely graying. We have changed the color of the eyes of the character. Dilbiji does have a mole, and he felt that was very important to remain and keep that true and real. You go through pigmentation, you're in the sun, you're stressed out. So there's a certain, that kind of natural reality we have brought to the visual conception of the character. And in that, you can bring in a similarity to me essaying her in reality, or even otherwise in the natural graph that you can imagine a character going through in her life, and what that would do to what you would visually see. So that is something we have maintained, even in terms of the lines of the clothes and all of that, you know, so, or the color or the fabric. I mean, it's that kind of thought on a daily basis to what was she doing that day, and would she just be mindlessly wearing her clothes, or would she even be thinking about it given what she's going through? So it's that kind of thought that goes into, and the reason I'm translating all this is because sometimes you all do not know. We don't talk about all this actually on a public platform, but that's how we work on characterization on a daily basis when telling stories of this genre and with this intensity.
Hi, this is Suhail.
Hi, hello.
He does not exist.
Can I just add, yeah. Because it's very selfish of me to take all the credit for my transformation. I think my makeup artist, Renuka Pillai, yeah, who did countless hours of tests on me, who we tried so many things, so many ways of bringing about this transformation. She worked for free just for the love of the movie and love of the works that the challenge that there was there. And the kind of detail, the God is in detail, the kind of details she's done. I think it'd be very selfish of me to take all the credit for my presentation, because she's really the person behind it. And to also tolerate my mood swings, because I was always starving. So thank you very much, Renuka.
Hi, this is Suhail.
Suhail from Subhash has done our, he has conceived the look of the film for the other characters. And Bhagyalakshmi worked with me. He's worked with me for years on hair. So yeah, we work together too, at every stage of the graying and all of that goes with the turf.
Yeah, hi, this is Suhail from Glamsham.
Suhail, 1 second. Can we have the last two questions from the media?
Yes, just the last two questions. Today we're here for Sarabjit and Darbir Kaur. We don't get to see you often, and the Panama Papers have been looming in the headlines. Do you have a clarification?
Excuse me.
Sarabjit.
Can we have your name, please?
Sarabjit.
Hi, this is Suhail from Glamsham.
A statement has been made to all of you, so I'm sure y'all already are aware of that. Thank you.
Yeah, my question is to Aishwarya, Umang, Randeep, and all of them. Like, you know, when the script had come to you, and right, like when we saw the first poster, in fact, like, you know, we had that kind of a feeling it's a powerful film. It will be getting lots of appraisal, applause, and definitely the awards also, actually. So do you get that kind of a feeling when the film is being made, or like after the look has come and people talking about it? Ek feeling aati hogi definitely, Umang ji,
I usually get petrified. I get scared when I get a script like this. How the hell I'm going to do it? Today is the day everybody's going to find out I'm not a good actor. That kind of fire in your ass, you work harder, bro.
Yeah, Ash, what's your take on this? Because when you read the script also right from the beginning, you know it's, as you said, like, you know.
Which one could lean on those choice of words, but.
You should.
I think, you know, we are just happy to get great scripts, wonderful films, and from therein, when you get a team like this to work with together, that's the fire that propels us. That's what keeps us excited and working as hard as we do, because we have genuinely really slogged every, I can't even say waking day, because there was hardly a sliver between the waking and the sleeping, because you're just going literally round the clock, immense pace. I still remember the first, he said, "Hope aega, Umang, are you serious? We'll do it. It will happen all along, and only we know how we've all come together. And if there's anything that the entire team needs an applause from us to ourselves, let alone begging you all to do so, is for the way this film has been made. That is our victory. That's our joy. And just today, the expressions on all our faces, we could see ours, we could not see behind. We heard you all. But we're all like, once more. Because we are all so happy with what we've just had a glimpse of. It's all our efforts, we've worked really hard. That's our greatest award and that's what's most exciting. To get that feeling at the end of every day of hard work and at the end of seeing the results of our efforts. That's the greatest award. Awards we graciously accept, we appreciate, we feel good for that minute. But it is the proof of the pudding. The film itself, our work and our efforts itself, that is our couple of months of effort. That's our life. You know, we all are living our lives virtually through our work, our every day, and that's being documented in pieces of cinema. And that's what is the greatest award we can ask for, and that's what's most meaningful.
Sandeep, I'm sorry to break your dreams. This is going to be the last
question. I have the mic.
Last question? Last question. Thank you.
Randeep, how did this preparation for the role, the solitary confinement, mood swings and all affect your personal relationships?
Everything thought I was an ass. Everybody thought I was an ass. You know, everybody around me had just had enough of me. I think it somewhere has affected me. I have to somewhere tell myself there's a certain sense of gloom that has come about since this movie, and I have to keep telling myself, look, you did not spend 22 years of your life in prison. You did not go through all that hardship. You did not go through solitary. There's something I have to keep reminding myself, and that has affected me, obviously. But so have other roles. So I hope, and they come out all at the wrong times.
Richa, Jackie,
over here.
I have a question for Richa.
Thank you.
You play his
Hi.
You play his wife.
Yes.
And I mean, he's someone you. He's someone you love in the movie. And then you say ki aap, you leave the fighting for others, and all you do is intazar. So how is it? How is this?
I don't think it's meant like that. I think that line is said in some kind of sarcasm. And when you see the film, you'll know the context of it, because. Talbir's character is really militant in fighting for the brother, but someone takes charge at home, and that person happens to be me. And that's the context of the statement.
Thank you.
Jackie, you should get to read the letters that Sarabjit wrote to his wife. They're so beautiful, with Rajesh Khanna songs and, aww, you know, such his you know, poetry, whichever he could, and how he longs for her. You should read those letters. That's really, really lovely.
They're really moving, actually.
Can we just have the last? This
Jackie,
the last
it's
question.
It's referenced in the movie, so you'll get to see
Jackie
that.
Over here.
You ask.
Who has the mic?
Over here, Jackie.
That's it. That's you're the one. You're the lucky girl. Okay.
Jackie, like it's nice to see you on stage in the capacity of a producer. Congratulations on your right. My question to you is, firstly, how have you been able to contribute to this creatively? And secondly, what does this mean for Jackie Bhagnani, the actor?
So as I said, that I know Umang Sir for a really long time. And when this came to us, Pooja Films was the first one to come on board. And as Umang Sir said that, you know, as someone asked earlier, that what about commerce and stuff like that? And the way he narrated the film, I just thought that this story should be told. And every film cannot have me as an actor, or would want me as an actor, or I could fit in. But I thought that it's the right film to back, and this story must be told, and that's why I'm standing here.
Thank you so much.
Now let's see the trailer once more.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's see the trailer once more.
Abhi bahut functions mein selfie welfie sab karte hain. I think I would like to request visually, if all the members of the media here in the foreground can just stand up, turn around, and since y'all are filming, can we give a round of applause, a salute to Dalbir ji, Supreet ji, Swapan, Poonam, the entire family who have lived this life. And we need to pay respects to them. So come on. Come on, help us. Come on, stand up. Turn around. They are watching, not photographers for a change. Turn kijiye. Ye aapke liye. Everybody applaud them.